Qualities of a good data collection procedure: validity issues. Dear students, when our research design is determined and we are to set on for data collection, we must make sure that our research instrument or procedure is really valid and it's really reliable. So in order to make it more valid, we must know the issues which are the part of creating validity within our research instrument or procedure, right? So we must know that what is validity and what are the issues which are the part of creating validity within a research design, or particularly for a data collection procedure. So for data collection procedure, when we talk about validity, it very simply means that we must have the data which is accurate, okay? So as already discussed, we should have reliable data and we should have a very valid data. So reliability is, you know, the internal consistency of the data, right? And validity is actually about the accuracy of the data. So the data, when it is collected in order to answer a particular research question, we must have a very reliable, very valid data. And as we have discussed reliability earlier, now in this session, we are going to talk about the validity issues, that how can we make our data valid? How can we create a quality data which is focused on answering our research question? And how would we be creating that quality within our data collection procedure or instrument, that our data, which is when it is collected, it is accurate, okay? So validity very simply is the ability of an instrument or observational procedure to capture data to answer a research question, right? So we must be capturing the actually authentically required data so that we can answer the research question, all right? So this ability to capture accurate data is our validity, and that's the validity of the instrument, okay? It's really a big question when we are required to collect data, that whether our data is valid or not, okay? And as a researcher, we must be able to evaluate the nature of our data collected, or the quality of our collected data, that what's the level of quality and is it really reliable or valid, right? So how it is valid, we must know that validity is a bit complex than reliability. Reliability is very simply the consistency of the results, okay? So you are replacing maybe the data collection timing or the data collection procedures, but your data, when it is coming to you, it's consistent, okay? No matter who is using your instrument, your hired assistant, or maybe you are collecting yourself the data, but it should be consistent. So that's the reliability. And the validity is that when you are actually using an instrument or a procedure, and that procedure is testing what it is supposed to test, okay? So actually it is testing what you are planning to test, what the research design is planned to highlight and test, okay? So that accuracy is basically called validity. Validity is quite important for every kind of research study. If it's not valid, then the whole a system is failed, and everything is in vain, okay? So we must have a very valid instrument for data collection. There are various types of validity, and as a researcher, we must be able to know those various types of validity, and we must also distinguish among them, that how can we create a particular a kind of validity, and how would we be using our very quality data collection procedure which is quite valid, okay? So those types of validity, very simply, there is content validity. And content validity very simply means that the data collected is logical, right? It's it's rational, okay? So it includes, the content validity basically includes every facet of of your, you know, construct, okay? And then we have predictive validity. Predictive validity is basically about the prediction of the results, okay? When the results are, you know, given, your results are basically predicting something in future, okay? And a very good example is that the language aptitude test. When a language aptitude test is taken and the data is collected, so that data would determine about the future performance of the test takers, right? So that's really the predictive validity, okay? We have another kind of, you know, validity, and that is face validity. Face validity, very simply, it's the, you know, it's the face of the instrument, okay? It's more about, in a very simple words, it's the cosmetic validity, right? So people, they do believe in your, you know, a procedure, your data collection procedure, right? So that's the repute of the procedure. That's, you know, the appearance of the procedure that people who are the stakeholders, maybe the public or the test takers or the teachers or the students or their parents, they do believe that whatever are, you know, the results, they are, you know, believable, right? So that's more about the appearance of the test, that it looks like a very valid, very, you know, authentic, very quality-based validity. So fast validity, it's about the appearance, that it appears to be very effective, right? So your test, your data collection procedure appears to be very effective. And it's the, you know, it's very transparent. People believe that that's very transparent. And it is, you know, relevant to the activity, right? So that appearance and that, you know, relevance and that transparency, they actually make together. They contribute towards the face validity. So face validity is also very important. And then we have another kind of validity, which is called construct validity. And construct validity is actually, you know, one of the three basic validities, like content validity, construct validity, or criterion validity, okay? So construct validity is really, you know, important for making your instrument valid, making it, you know, quite reliable. And that's the point. The point is that it includes every trait, okay? The construct validity is that it includes every trait and the utility of the trait. And it's the, you know, the part of the validity. Every aspect of the construct is covered. So that's the construct validity. These kinds of various kinds of validity are important and must be known to researchers. And the instrument or the observational procedure must be created keeping in mind these various types of validity. And the point is that whatever trait is evaluated, it is assessed through an observational procedure or through an instrument, it is really accurate, okay? And the trait accuracy is there, okay? And then the construct validity is there, because the trait, when it is the aspects, the various aspects of the same construct, when they are taken into account while defining the construct, while giving, you know, while creating the, you know, the test of the for data collection, then those facets, those aspects of construct, they were considered and they were taken into account. So it's valid. And whatever is collected through using this instrument or data collection procedure, it gives us the answers which are focused and which would definitely answer your research questions. So your instrument or your observational procedure must not only be reliable, but it should also be valid. When your observational procedure or when your instrument is valid, when it's reliable, then the research questions are fully addressed. And the study, the design is authentic.